My name is Richard Kelly, and I am Professor and Chair in the Department of Geography and Environmental Management at the University of Waterloo. I wanted to talk to you today about our geomatics degree plan, what it is, why it matters, and how you can be part of it. First, what is geomatics? Well, over 80% of the world's information has a location component associated with it. Geomatics is the science of recording and analyzing the surface of the Earth. You're seeing here a zoom in to the University of Waterloo and our faculty. Here's a map of where our geese are. Why where matters is really important, because analyzing why and where is all about location, and it's about how it impacts health, economy, climate, sustainability, and much more. So in geomatics at Waterloo, you'll gain a strong foundation in all sorts of things related to the why, where matters. We will take you into elements of software development, technology, and environmental analysis. You'll learn how to apply these skills to a range of industries. You'll learn to use tools such as unpiloted aerial vehicles or drones, remote sensing, computer mapping, geographic information systems, and GPS, which drives much of what we do. You'll also learn the fundamentals of software design, and that you'll do through University of Waterloo's world-class Cheriton School of Computer Science. And because we'll train you in some advanced tools and techniques to use in industry, you'll hit the ground running from day one of your career. So let's just dip into what geomatics is. There are three pillars to it that we think about. The first would be remote sensing, data capture. So here you're seeing a series of images taken from probably about 700 kilometers above the Earth from an orbiting satellite, where we're looking at the opening of the Northwest Passage in northern Canada. And you can see that between May and September in 2007, that slither of water became more and more open, allowing the passage of ships to transfer through. We also use suborbital systems such as drones or unpiloted airborne vehicles. Here we'll train you how to use these systems for environmental applications and environmental monitoring. We can also use traditional methods of surveying and mapping to create 3D building structures from ground-based laser systems. This is a fairly new area of expertise that you'll be exposed to. At Waterloo, we also like remote sensing in terms of how we might experiment with it. This is an example where we're experimenting with something as simple as a balloon. And we use that balloon as a platform to mount a camera that can be positioned just below the balloon and take imagery and photographs of the ground below. So the second pillar is what we like to think is geographic information systems. This is the way that we take data, we integrate it into a computer environment, and we analyze the data that we've got. So in this instance, for the example you're seeing here, we're mapping the spatial distribution of police services reports from low importance to high importance. And then we're also mapping the emergency response time of particular fire services and fire stations. These are the kinds of things that we can do with geographic information systems. In this example, for a GIS, you're looking at how we can use GIS to predict coastal flood exposure from storm surges over the next 100 years, perhaps as a result of climate change. The red areas indicate where you have extreme flooding from the 100-year storm, whereas the blue areas are the smaller flooding events that might occur a little bit more frequently. And then the final element of geomatics is the more traditional surveying aspect of the discipline. So we train you to use modern ground survey equipment, total survey stations, the kinds of things that you might see at the side of the road, but also GPS surveying as well. That kind of knowledge is critical because we can take it, we can do all the things that the construction industry, but we can also take that knowledge and apply it in the case of understanding where our planet's going in the future. So for example, we have had researchers who are interested in surveying beach heights in the Caribbean for climate model forecasts. How would sea level change? What's the impact going to be on human society? So surveying is one of those pieces that really helps us to provide the data for which our geomatics analysis is conducted. So why geomatics at Waterloo? Waterloo is globally recognized in both geography and computer science. At Waterloo, you'll have access to high-tech labs and equipment. You'll receive comprehensive training in tools and techniques that are also used in industry. And with co-op experience, you'll graduate with 20 months worth of work experience. You can get an education that combines geography and computer science at an institution that's distinguished in both fields. Waterloo Geography is ranked in the top 5 in Canada, and the Cheriton School of Computer Science is ranked in the top 50 in the world. And then access to these high-tech labs and comprehensive training tools really allow you to seamlessly transition from the classroom into the workplace. Experiential learning is one of the key elements of what we think about when we teach and train in our geomatics plan at Waterloo. You graduate with 20 months worth of work experience. And here's a picture of one of our students, Ogis, who's conducting a GPS and a laser scanning survey outside our building. Ogis spent one term working for Statistics Canada as a remote sensing and geospatial analyst. He also worked at the York region working with water and waste management. Just two examples of five of the co-ops that Ogis did. Here's another of our students helping Ogis in the field as well. You'll gain hands-on experience and advanced technical skills in our training, which really allows you to develop in the workplace and gives you access to work positions. And we've had students that take many different types of co-op experiences, smaller geospatial data startup companies. We've had students working at Google, at Amazon, environmental consultancies, local, provincial, and federal government positions as well. And the kind of positions range from geographic information analysts to coding specialists to data analysts and environmental consultants. Another example would be Andrea. We asked her why did she choose geomatics. You can see the quote there. If you're interested in how technology intersects with nature and society, geomatics is definitely a path worth pursuing. Just be ready to learn and to learn fast. Available technologies are always changing and it's pretty exciting. And Andrea is a really interesting case study. She is now conducting graduate studies in our program. She grew up in the former Czech Republic and in Ukraine, and experienced at first hand some of the geopolitical conflicts in her childhood that were a part of the early 90s. And one of the great things that she has said to us many times is the passion that she has for geomatics comes from that experience as to how the planet was changing in that time and how we can now use these kinds of technologies to track and to understand the impact of those changes that we see geopolitically. So you've decided that geomatics might be of interest to you. What's in it in your first year in the program? Well, it's pretty tied up, I'll be honest, but what we do is we give you a pretty good grounding in the first two terms. From September to December, you'll take foundations in geographic information science. You'll learn about how to engage with problem solving in geomatics. You'll take some implied environmental data management and statistics in EMVS 178. And then you get to choose one of two computer science courses, and you also get to choose one of two math courses as well. As you move into the second term, in the winter term, you're looking at taking courses that build on the principles and foundations from that first term. So Geography 281 is really all about the foundations of geographic information systems in application terms. You'll take applied statistics for environmental research. And then you'll also get to choose one of two courses, Geography 101 or Geography 102, which kind of start to broaden things out in terms of the applied side of geomatics and how it leads in with geography, other parts of the degree programs that we have in geography. We get to choose one of CS 116 or CS 136, so Introduction to Computer Science 2 or Elementary Algorithm Design and Data Abstraction. And then you have to take an English course at second term as well. Having taken the first year, you'll then move on to the second year. And at that point, you might start to think about specializing in certain areas. And we have four different specializations as you track into the second, third, and fourth years that you might want to look at. You can take one of the specializations, climate change and environment. It's all about climate change, both from the physical to the impacts, adaptations, and maybe mitigation of climate change and how that impacts the environment and sustainability. The second specialization is in Earth System Science. That area is really about some of the physical geography aspects of our planet. And with geomatics under your belt, it gives you a really good opportunity to explore how geomatics can be applied in the context of the physical environment. So whether that's in wetlands reclamation, whether it's in hydrology, whether it's in geomorphology or glaciology, or even in climate as well. These are all the sorts of things that we think about in system science. In economy and society, you'll learn about how does the economy work? How do we think about the economy in developing countries? How do we think about sustainability in the economy? How do we think about the fact that the world of work is changing from very career-oriented positions to the gig economy? And then we also have a fourth specialization in aviation, which is something that will be available in the next year or so. That's really all about sustainability in the aviation industry and how this is something that we have to pay attention to as we move forward. So those are the specializations. In addition, the fact that you're also taking four computer science courses over your degree means that you'll be eligible for the computing option. And that gives you an extra credential, which really reflects the nature of that computing piece that is such an important part of the geomatics degree. Co-op and careers. What will that do for me in the future? Well, we've already said that co-op is one of the pieces that you can take and one of the elements that you can really engage with in our program. You'll graduate with 20 months of work experience. You'll also earn between $38,000 and $85,000 over 5 terms to help to pay for school. You can grow your network and you can try out different careers through the co-op pathway. And I think that's a really important thing to think about. If you decide not to take co-op, you can fast track into a 4-year degree option, which is a non-co-op track, but gives you some opportunities there as well. In co-op, we also provide professional development courses that really help you to prepare you for interview, write your resume, and how to approach that all-important job interview that you'll need to do when you're going for your co-op positions. Waterloo is one of the best places for co-op that you'll find probably on the planet. 79% of co-op grads earn 50,000 plus, compared with 38% of Ontario graduates. 96% of our co-op grads work in jobs related to their program, and 91% employment rate for Waterloo compares with 87% or less from some of our Ontario competitors. So the University of Waterloo really is a global leader in cooperative education. And we have the largest co-op program of its kind, which is kind of twice as many students as any of our closest competitors in this field. So we take this very seriously. So what kind of co-op positions would you find if you were in geomatics plan? Kind of jobs that we see our students taking might include something like a GIS technician at Statistics Canada, might include a data analyst at Natural Resources Canada. We've had students in co-op positions who are engaged in GIS and data management at regional municipalities, or we've had IT interns at all sorts of different companies, such as telecom companies or some of the big tech companies like Google and Apple as well. In terms of how this factors in and how this works with your study terms, we talked about the first year where you take 2 terms back to back, fall and then into the winter, and then you have the spring term off. When you come back in your second year, you'll take a study term in the fall, and then in the following winter, that's when the co-op program really starts, and that's when you'll have your first placement in the winter of your second year. And then what you'll find is that you'll alternate between being in class and being on work term, being in class and being in work term, and you just alternate through until the winter term of your 5th year when you graduate. If you decide that you don't want to do co-op, you can actually do your degree in 4 years. And that's a much more standard approach to the degree program that you see in other universities, but we're able to do that as well. The great thing about taking the 4-year program is that you can use your summers off to travel, work, or volunteer. You can also take classes in the summer to graduate even sooner. And we also have something called the EDGE certificate, which is your opportunity to develop professional skills, which sets you up for the workplace at the end of your 4-year degree as well. So the kinds of careers in geomatics, once you're finished, well, you can apply your degree in a range of industries. And you can think of as many industries as you possibly can. And we probably have had people working in those industries. But the insurance industry, for example, collecting and analyzing data to understand the costs and risks of extreme weather. In government, we've had students who ended up in careers tracking crime rates or even the instance of disease across the population. We had students right now with the COVID-19 incidents who are working to look at patterns of spatial epidemiology. How do these diseases track across a continent or across a region? We have students who finish their geomatics degree and end up in retail, where they're looking at mapping demographics to identify new clients or locations for expansion. And of course, in municipalities, where you're trying to plan efficient transportation routes, how will the land be used or community services be provided? There's a range of sample jobs that you can see. We've kind of touched on some of these already. GIS specialist, software engineer, developer, tech support specialist for tech company. Okay, so you've decided that geomatics is what you want to do. We hope you have, at least. Well, how do you go about coming in and what are the admissions requirements? You probably know this already, but the admission requirements require an average of low 80s. We require two courses, any grade 12U English, minimum 70%. And we also require grade 12U math course, any grade 12U math course with a minimum of 70% as well. We also recommend a couple of other courses at 12U, one or more 12U science or math, and any grade 12U course in a second language. The recommended courses don't affect the likelihood of you being admitted, but are recommended really to help you succeed in your studies when you actually get here. So you've gone through your high school, you've got your grade, you've decided to come. Are there scholarship opportunities that you might be able to take? Well, the answer is yes. So entrance scholarships, if you end up with a 95% or above, you will automatically be eligible for a $4,000 entry scholarship. That consists of a Waterloo entrance scholarship and an environment entrance scholarship. And there are other scholarships from the 90 to 95% and 85 to 90% range that you'll be eligible for as well. So every student admitted to full-time first-year studies in the Faculty of Environment is automatically considered for these scholarships. No application is required for these scholarships. You must accept your offer admission by the date specified on the offer to remain eligible for these scholarships. Additional application-based scholarships specific to the Faculty of Environment is also available. So the environment scholarships, we have a couple. We have the Dean's Scholarship for Excellence. This is a nice one. This is worth $7,500 over the first two terms in the first year. And we have five of these that are awarded each year. There's also an Environment Student Engagement Award, which is all about recognizing your volunteer work in the environment or in sustainability. And we have up to 25 of these typically awarded each year, and they're usually around about $2,000 each. If you want to be considered for one of these awards, you have to complete an application form. An email will be sent to all applicants once the application is open, and if you have an admission of average of 85% or higher, then you're eligible to apply for these two scholarships as well. Finally, if you have any questions about geomatics at Waterloo, here's some contact information for you. You can email us, or you can Snapchat us or Facebook us, or you can use Instagram to get in touch with us as well. Thank you very much for listening. I hope this has given you a good understanding of geomatics at Waterloo, and I wish you all the best of luck in the future.